warn listeners in advance so they may have the option of turning the radio off for 30 seconds while it plays. It has always haunted me. To those who discounted the Siberia sounds from Hell's Story, it is true, and I, for one, wish it wasn't. Rick, listening from Chicago. And so I submit now the cleaned, a better copy to you, and I warn you, what you are about to hear is very disturbing indeed.
Most of you will end up at the end of your time, so please keep playing church. Get ready for an unbelievable time of joy and happiness, or not. That's what I made this witch into believing. She thought her life would be full of joy if she sold her soul to me. We have pastors here who never took care of their hidden secrets. Some who never preached about the reality of this place. We have Christians who never had a relationship with their God. We have people who made their gods sex, drugs, and rock and roll. And now they get to enjoy me 24/7, worshiping me forever. And we have atheists who believe there was no such thing as a living God. You stupid fool. He was all around you, calling out to you. I even knew that. Worship me now. Worship me, you idiots. I am your only God now. And forever you will be mine. You are all mine, and you. Don't worry. You'll see us again.
And so the Bible tells us in John chapter 10, verse 10, it says that the enemy comes to steal, kill, and destroy. You know what? The topic about the enemy, usually sometimes a lot of people think it's fake. And I know we're sitting here in this Bible study, but as I'm talking to you, just as the person that is next to you is real, look at the person that is next to you. Just as real as that person that is next to you, the enemy is also real. But the thing about it is that we can't see the enemy. So a lot of people say, well, you know what? The enemy does not exist because I can't see him. Well, just because we can't see the air, just because we can't see the wind doesn't mean the air and wind don't exist. Just know that there's an enemy who is out to get you. Just know that there's an enemy who wants to destroy your life. You guys understand that word tonight? Let's go ahead and bow our heads and pray. Lord, we thank you, Lord, and I thank you for these students that were able to come out to this Bible study, Lord, and we have been here, Lord, tonight teaching about your word. And I pray, Lord, that you may help them, Lord, when they're at school. I pray that you may help them when they're at work, Father God. Lord, I pray that you may help them anywhere they are at, Lord, every day of their life. I pray that this word that has been preached to them, they may put it into practice tonight. We say all this in your name, in the name of Jesus Christ we pray, and everyone says,
Amen. Amen.
Hey, Alex, can I have a word with you?
What's up, Pastor Jake?
First of all, I want to thank you for coming out to the Bible study.
Yeah.
I did not expect to see you, but I did have a question. I wanted to ask you, how are your parents doing?
My parents. That's actually funny because my mom and dad actually have they love each other, don't get me wrong, but it's just a hard kind of love, if you know what I mean.
There's a lot of problems at
home. There's just a lot of tension, maybe. It's my dad. It started off with my dad, actually. He's the one that's kind of like, how can I put it?
Hey, Alex. Alex, can I talk to you? Hurry, because I have to tell you something. Come on.
Okay. It's fine.
Yeah.
Can we talk on Sunday?
Sure, yeah. Okay, we can do that. Okay, thanks. Cool. Awesome.
Can you tell me why you invited her again, bro?
I mean, look at her. She needs Jesus, right?
Hey, guys.
Hey.
Hey, how are you? Not much is here, the Bible study, as you can see.
Cool, I guess.
How'd you enjoy it?
I thought it was boring.
Boring?
Oh,
yeah.
Wait, just the invite I gave to you.
Boring.
Okay. Boring?
Yeah.
Why boring?
I don't know. I just don't believe in any of that stuff. I can kind of care less. Yeah.
You believe in Victoria's Secret?
Yeah, I actually do.
Okay, well, yeah.
What is Victoria's Secret?
It's some secret that she's been keeping from people.
Oh, you're so funny, Alex.
Okay.
So, what are y'all gonna do tonight?
I'm gonna go home, I'm gonna eat some food, and I'm gonna digest it and probably go to sleep.
Digest?
That's interesting.
Kind of
I would probably do the same thing though. It's fun.
That's why we're best friends, bro.
Yeah, definitely. Mm. Actually, they're having a Friday the 13th marathon.
Oh,
and
so cool.
I love to see people get murdered.
Yeah, it's so cool. Anyway, so other than Digestion Boy, what do y'all two want to do tonight? I was thinking we should all go out since it's Halloween night. Maybe the Vein?
What's the Vein?
The Vein?
Yeah.
You know that's a club, right?
Duh.
You want?
What's
he's
the
a Christian.
Vein?
He,
is that like
go
a
there?
Vampire
so
place?
You can go there.
Look. No, it's this ridiculous nightclub.
Ridiculous?
It's ridiculous.
It's
like good ridiculous? Cause
yeah, it's like really good ridiculous.
No, it's bad ridiculous. It's full of drunk people, dancing, flirtatious, stupid stuff, bro.
It's called nice. Fun.
Sounds like family get-togethers.
Yeah, it's not.
But,
hey, Alex, can I talk to you, please?
Yeah, Sarah. Excuse me, Tanya. I have to attend my mistress now.
Okay.
Later. What's up, Sarah?
Probably one of these stupid fools who pretend you have it all together, huh? You go to church on Sundays, Tuesdays, and you're saying, yeah, I have it all down to the bone. I must be saved since I go to church. I read my Bible every once in a while and pray before I go to bed. You silly fool, if you only knew what we were up to. You have great plans for your life. We have plans for you that you would never imagine if no one ever told you I was real. Surprise! I'm real. And I'm all around. I see and know all your hidden secrets. I know what you do when no one is looking. And I know what you've done. But don't worry. I won't tell anyone. After all, I'm your friend. And you can trust me. I promise. Let's see what our girl Sarah has been keeping from Alex. She has a little secret that's been killing her inside. And as for you, we'll be seeing you very soon.
Jake's message is really good tonight, right?
Whoa, what's
yeah,
wrong with you?
It had me thinking. Maybe we should go back to church.
What's wrong with you? Why are you all nervous and stuff?
Alex. What? I love you.
Yeah, I know you love me, babe. What's your problem? Are you okay?
No.
You can tell me anything, remember?
Alex, I know.
Okay, well then?
There's something I've been wanting to tell you.
Then just tell me. Why are you acting all weird?
Oh, I can do this. Okay, Alex.
Yeah? Tell me.
Alex, I'm pregnant, Alex.
You're pregnant? What do you mean you're pregnant?
I know. I thought we were safe. I don't know what happened.
I thought we were safe too. We used a freaking condom for crying out loud.
I know we used it, but it's only 99.9 effective. And I don't know what to do.
Do you know what my parents would do if they found out? They would kill me.
I know, Alex. Imagine me. I'm already 2 months, Alex. I don't know what to do.
You're 2 months. That's a good thing. I've heard my friends that just get rid of babies like at 1, 2
months.
Oh my God. You don't feel a thing.
No, Alex, are you kidding me? No, I can't. I can't
Sarah,
kill a baby.
Would you stop already? We have to.
We have to get rid of this baby. It's for our own good. Listen to me. There's like an abortion clinic around here somewhere, and I heard that they just inject you with some kind of fluid, and then it's over, quick and fast, I promise you. Listen to me. We're gonna get rid of that baby for our own good, and we're just gonna pretend as if it never happened, okay? It never happened.
It happened, Alex.
So, Zach.
Hey, man, are you ready to go?
Hi, Alex.
All they're talking about is how the pastor looks like Tom Cruise.
Tom Cruise?
Yeah.
More like Thor.
Thor?
Have you guys even seen that movie?
Thor's an Australian. No. That pastor's a Mexican.
Come on.
So? Is there a resemblance?
Not really. Thor has long, luscious locks.
Okay, so are we going out tonight, or?
I don't know. I don't think we...
Ghostbusters?
No, come out tonight.
No,
I think we're going to take off. I'll drive.
See ya, whatever.
Just let me know if you're going to come out, okay, Alex?
Yeah, okay, Tanya, shut up. Hey, Ma.
Hi, son. How was school?
It was good. Bible study was interesting, but there's this girl, Tanya, and she, I don't know, she's just all over me, you know, like Lady in the Tramp style. I don't know, it's just weird.
Son, didn't I teach you better?
Yeah, but I mean, look at you and Dad. But anyways, I was just, what is that? What is that? Is that a Bible?
Yes, I was just remembering about my mom.
When's the last time I saw you with a Bible, Mom?
I know, but... just started thinking about my mom and
yeah, I remember Grandma giving you that. It's like all dusty and stuff. Wow, you haven't read that in a while.
Yeah.
Anyways.
But, you know.
Yeah, you know, Pastor Jake, right?
Yeah. Why?
Well, I was talking to him.
You whore!
That was you.
What?
You don't think I know about it?
What, Frank?
Cecilia told me about that guy you're out with.
What? Oh my God! Are you serious?
Who's this guy you're out with?
Oh my God, that was Pastor Jake!
You talked to him, man?
Nobody's talking.
What's your problem?
Get off of me, old man!
Get off of him!
Get out of here! Johnny, get out of your business! Go to your room!
Leave him alone! Get off of him!
It's Pastor Jake!
I already told you who it was!
What's your problem?
With this Pastor Jake?
I already told you!
Who else you out there with another guy?
It's not another guy! Leave me alone!
You cheating on me?
I'm not cheating on you!
I'm not cheating on you, Dad!
What's this?
What?
What's this text then?
Oh my God! Yes, I am.
Mom, Dad, get off of her!
Leave me alone.
Get off of her!
Leave me alone!
Why don't y'all just freaking end it already? Always fighting.
It's all your fault.
I hate this freaking family. All they do is argue. My mom just lets that crap happen to her. My dad's a freaking junkie. Family's stupid. They can go to hell for all I care. It's only one thing that makes me feel better. If I could just remember how they told me to do it. Hello? What do you want, Tanya? Yeah. No, do you know what you did? You practically made it seem like we were together at the Bible study in front of Sarah. Yeah. Yeah, if she ever found out that I was cheating on her, do you know what she would do to me? I'd be so dead.
Hey, yeah. Alex.
Johnny, what are you doing in here? Get out of here. Get out of my room. How many times am I gonna tell you? Get out of here! It's my freaking brother walking on me while I have stuff out. Look. Yeah. Okay, yes, I know it's a costume party. All right, just give me like 10 minutes and I'll be there. You're coming for me? Okay, yeah, okay. Yeah. Whatever, shut up.
Alex. Oh, shoot. Alex. Mom. what is this?
So good. I can't believe she chooses a vampire with a werewolf.
Right? Tell me about it. I mean,
he's so good. I know, man. I mean, have you seen his ass? I mean, of course. Dude, oh my gosh. Sometimes I feel like my brother's a werewolf. I mean, have you seen how his back looks? Like, hairy. It's like, sure.
Tell me about it. My dad.
Oh, that's sick. Gross. Oh, hey, so have you seen that movie Paranormal Activity? I just... it's on my mind all day.
Scary. Can somebody tie this on my
head?
Like tight, kind of tight.
Yeah, I've seen it. Really? Well, isn't it crazy how she practically kills herself in the end?
I guess, but like, kind of weird.
You know, people can actually make themselves die.
What do you mean?
You know, like literally kill themselves, like. They say the fastest ways is like with pills.
Pills? Like Tylenol and stuff?
Yeah, crazy, right?
Yeah, I guess.
Okay, so back to the real reason why I brought you here.
What are you talking about?
You know, the game I've been telling you all day about.
I don't know, Abby. The Ouija board is kind of weird and scary.
Oh my gosh, come on. Don't be such a chicken. It's actually fun. You just gotta give it a try. Ugh, don't even get me started. They left arguing. They're so stupid.
Shut up! At least you have parents. I miss my mom so much.
Well, maybe we can look for her with the Ouija board.
Do you know how to work it?
Are you kidding me? Of course I do. Okay, so let's get the stuff ready.
You just said it wasn't!
Oh my gosh, take a joke. I'm just messing with you.
Hey. Don't mess with me like that.
Here, you try it.
Well, hello there, Abby and Misty. It's nice of you to let me ask you. Go ahead and play away. Seek your lost mother, Misty. Let's see if she really replies. I've had Abby here in a trap for a while now. Ever since her parents left the church, she turns to magic and mystics for a way out to comfort her or feel some kind of love. Since she's dry and stone cold inside, the only thing she runs to is the powers of something far greater than she can ever imagine. Oh, if you only knew what you allow us to do with your soul, and most of you just let us in like nothing. So we thank you. We applaud you. Keep messing with us, and we'll give you everything you desire. If you're willing, we'll even drag your soul with us to hell. So, let's get back to Abby and Misty. They're dying to have some fun tonight. And boy, are we ready to surprise them.
No, you want me to try it? I know how to work this thing.
All you gotta do is just ask to see if anything's here.
Okay, okay. Spirits, if you're here,
yourself known? Come on,
Abby! Oh my gosh, Missy, don't do that. You scared me.
This is such bull, Abby. It's not going to do anything. I'm never going to see my mom again.
Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh, it's so just bulls right now, Missy.
No. No, that can't be real.
It is real, Missy. I'm not messing with you. Now ask to see if it's a good spirit.
Oh, of course we're here.
It said yes. It said yes.
So what?
Ask to see if it's your mom. Maybe it is. Ask.
Mom, is that you?
Let's lie to her to give her comfort. Yes.
Mom, if it's really you, please, show yourself. I miss you so much.
This is Missy's mom. If it's you, show us that you're here. No, Missy! Oh my gosh! No, Missy! Don't move!
Check him with fear!
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the Bang, the hottest, sexiest place in town. Are you having a good time tonight? Don't forget it, ladies, if you're 21 and older, free drinks from 11 a.m. to 11 2 a.m. Get wild, go crazy, happy Halloween!
Yeah, I mean, just a little loud, though.
Yeah, it is. I come around the tunnel, it's actually deaf.
Oh, it's not good. It's not good at all.
Hey, yeah. Oh, my God!
Justin! This is my best friend, Jasmine. We were in high school here together.
You basically say everything
the same!
Nice to meet you, Jasmine.
Hey, I want to be a snoop.
Not what I said, weirdo.
You.
I bet she does. What did she say?
Hey, that's kind of not important right now. But do we come here to have fun or what?
Woo!
Is that Eric over there?
Who's Eric?
He's the guy from the Bible study.
Shut up,
this
really?
Morning. Yeah, he's over.
Oh my gosh. Where is he? I love a bad Christian boy.
Oh my gosh.
Yeah, you would. I'm just gonna go say hi to him real quick.
Okay,
right?
This will take too long talking.
Whatever. Eric!
Alex!
Bro, what are you doing here? What are you doing here, man?
We're just telling this girl about Jesus.
No, you weren't, liar. That's not ministering at all, man.
Hey, where are you going?
Okay. Who the heck brought you, man?
Actually, some friends from work invited me. They said there'd be food, there'd be girls, and I figured, hey, I can't pass that up. I mean, you're here, right?
Yeah, but I mean, it's not really, like, amazing or anything like that.
Yeah.
Does your mom know you're here?
Of course she does, bro.
Really?
No, man, please don't tell her.
I won't, but I just came with, like, a couple of friends.
Alex, you're taking too long. Come on.
This is Tanya.
No, let's go.
All right.
I'll talk to you at church.
I was trying to talk to that guy over there.
Nobody came to have fun with me, didn't you?
Yeah, I did. No, I didn't. I'm gonna dance with Jasmine.
Okay.
Hey, Jasmine.
Why? Hey, look at this. Isn't that your friend right over there? He looks like he's getting into some trouble. Look.
He's engaged to trouble.
No, look.
Oh, shoot. Eric! Stay away from that guy. He's got a gun!
Thank you.
what happened to me last night. It was so crazy.
Tanya.
And then I saw like this group of people like dancing. I don't know what they were doing. And I saw my best friend Jasmine. I love her so much. But where did everybody go? Jasmine? Jasmine!
You can't leave me.
Jasmine, I'm right here. What are you talking about?
I need you.
What are you talking about? You need me? I'm right here. Is there anybody else still out there? Alex, Stephanie, what's wrong with Tanya? Why is she crying? Why is everybody...
You're right with me the whole time.
What's wrong? Why is everybody not listening to me? What's going on?
I can't be dead.
I can't be what? What do you mean dead?
What happened to my baby? What happened to her?
I'm so sorry.
No. My baby,
oh my God!
Died. Why did you bring her here?
No.
Why? Get away from her!
What happened? No. Mom, what happened to you? I'm so scared. No, my baby. Mommy, you can stop this, Mommy. Mommy, you can stop this. You just have to wake me up, Mom. Mom, just wake me up, Mom. Mommy, just have to wake me, Mom. No. Stop, you can stop this, Mom. You can stop this. I'm so scared. No, Mom, don't leave me, Mom. Mom, stop. Where are you going? Mom, come back. No, I can't be dead. I can't be dead. No, this can't be real. What happened last night? What happened to me? I can't be dead. What happened? That man. He shot that guy from the Bible study. I looked. No! He shot me too! Tanya! I can't be. No, I had so much going for me. This can't be real. I was so young. I was only 23 years old. This can't be real. Tanya, you need to wake up. Is there anybody else out there? Can somebody help me, please? Somebody help wake me up. Somebody help me. Tanya, wake up. Tanya, can somebody help me? Tanya. Wake up! No, this can't be real. Where do I go from now? Isn't that God guy supposed to save me? Where is he at? God, help me, I'm right here. Where are you, God? Where are you? Somebody wake me up, please. This just can't be real. No. No, Tanya, wake up. I had so much going for me. What did I do? Oh my God, Tanya! You need to wake up, Tanya! Tanya, wake up! Stop, get away! Tanya, wake up, Tanya! Tanya! Tanya, stop! Wake up, Tanya! You need to wake up! No! Stop! Go! Tanya!
Club was crazy. I ain't doing that again.
There won't be another time, Derek.
Alex? Is that you? Alex? Why is it so cold? Alex, where are you? Guys, this isn't funny. My mom's gonna freak if she finds out where I was at. This dude is wasted. Hey, buddy. Come on, man, it's time to go home. Hey, wake up already. Call this guy a cab. No, must be drunk. Must be drunk. It gotta look like me. That is me. Oh my God. What happened? I can't be dead here. No.
You're never going to wake up, Eric.
Wake up, Eric. Wake up. No! I was shot! The guy at the club! Okay. If I'm dead, I was good. I did good things. If I'm dead, that means I'm going to heaven. I'm ready, Lord! Come and get me, Lord! I'm ready for you! Lord, where are you? Lord, don't leave me here. Lord, you can't leave me behind. I did so many good things. I gave my offering. I was a youth leader. I brought people to your kingdom. You can't leave me.
Thought you were safe, didn't you? But did you forget what the old man's book says? It's not by works. Get him! God never turned on you, you idiot!
No! No! This isn't real!
Thank you.
love again. No, maybe I shouldn't. No, come on, Misty. Maybe if I take three. Maybe if I take three. No, four. All right, come on, Misty, don't be scared. This is to leave all the pain and suffering. I mean, Dad will probably know I'm gone. He'll probably be more than happy to see me dead. I mean, all he does is yell on and on about stupid stuff. He doesn't even love me like you did, Mom. I don't even know you. I don't even know what I'm doing. But it's to see you. So maybe, come on, don't be scared. This is for the jerk you've been, Dad. You forgot about me!
My girlfriend just called me. I'm just coming right now from. I just came right now from okay. outing with friends, and she called me,
sir,
and she told
down.
Me that she's bleeding
okay,
intensely,
calm
and that.
Down, sir, calm down. What is her name?
Her name's Sarah Rodriguez, and I just really caught. She just.
Okay.
She called me, and she really needs to know that I'm here, please.
I understand that. You need to have a seat. There's patients out here. Please have a seat. Keep calm. I will check right now. Please
okay,
have a
yeah.
seat.
All right.
Oh my God, doctor! Alex, where are you, Alex?
Did you hear that? She just called my name. I heard her right now. She just called my name. Don't tell me you didn't hear that, please.
I need you to keep calm. She's in ICU right now. There's nobody can step into that room. I need you to have a seat. Okay. Keep calm. I will check for you right now. So please.
If you could just let her know that her boyfriend Alex is here.
Okay.
Just let her know, please, that I'm here.
Please
just let her know. Let her know. Let her know, please.
Someone please, someone help me, please. Where is everybody? Oh my God, y'all promised me this wouldn't hurt. Alex, you said you'd be here, where are you?
Doctor,
help me, please! Someone please help me! Oh! Oh! Oh!
You're coming to hell with us, Sarah.
I didn't want to do this. I didn't want to do this. Please, I don't want to die.
You're coming home with us, Sarah.
God, I know you can hear me. Please. God, I wanted to give you my all. I promise. I wanted to give you my all, God. I didn't want to do this, please. I'm so sorry. I'm so sorry, God. This. God, please. God, please, just give me another chance. God, I'm so sorry, please. God, 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 I need you.
Yeah, but I'm the one that told her. I told her to do it, and she died.
God has a plan for everything, man.
Don't talk to me about God, Zach. I don't need that crap. Johnny, what are you doing on the floor? Get up. Stop being dumb.
I'll get him.
Leave him alone, man. He's being stupid. Get up, Johnny.
Okay. He's not moving.
He's fine, man. He always just stays up playing video games and eats and just goes to sleep anywhere. I know him.
He's not getting up. You want to come take a look for yourself?
He's okay, dude. Just leave him alone. Get up, Johnny. Johnny, get up. Go to your room, dumb butt. Johnny. Johnny, get up. Johnny. Johnny, wake up. Oh my God. Call 911, Zach. Call 911. He took my drugs. Johnny. You weren't supposed to take those, Johnny! Johnny, come on, why would you do that, Johnny? No, 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 Johnny. No, no. Johnny, why didn't you take those? Oh, God, no, 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 no. Johnny,
Alex.
Come on.
Alex, I'm
sorry.
Alex! Mom. Ah! Come on, what did you do?
I didn't mean to do it! You took my drugs, I didn't mean to do it! John, I'm so sorry. I didn't mean to do it. I didn't mean to do it. I'm sorry. Mama. I'm sorry. Johnny. Wake up, Johnny. Johnny. Wake up, Johnny. Johnny. I'm so sorry. I'm so sorry, Mama. I didn't mean to do it.
Get away.
I didn't mean to do it. No! Johnny's dead. No! No, God! This is your fault! You killed Johnny! You killed my brother, Lord! You did! It was you, God! And my mom hates me! She wants me dead!
That's what it was. If I was gone, they wouldn't care. I should just die. I should just kill myself. Nobody would care. This is your fault. You're the one that did this to me. I hate you. God, I hate you. You were never there for me. Never. There is no such thing as a hell. Not in my world.
Ha ha.
worship me. All of you idiots. All of you fools. All of you. Worship me now. Worship me. You fools. Worship me now.
The Bible says in John chapter 10, verse 10, that the enemy comes to steal, kill, and destroy. But then Jesus says, I have come to give you life. You have the choice to choose death or choose life. It's up to you. So as you're here sitting down in this Bible study, I pray that God may help you everywhere you go, everywhere you're at. I pray that God is always with you. Just know this. There is a real person, just as real as the person is next to you. That's how real the enemy is. The thing is that sometimes we don't think the enemy is real because we don't see him. But just know that there is an enemy that is wanting to destroy each and every one of you. You guys understand that tonight? Let's go ahead and bow our heads and pray. Lord, I pray for these students. Lord, I thank you, Lord, that they were able to make it, Lord, to this Bible study, Father God. But I just pray that the word that has been preached, Father God, that it may go wherever they are at, Father God. I pray that you may help them while they go to school. I pray that you may help them while they go to work, Father God. And Lord, I pray that you may protect them, Lord, because we know that there is an enemy who wants to steal, kill, and destroy, Father God. But we know that you have come to give these young people life. Lord, I just pray that you may protect them. In the name of Jesus Christ, we pray. And everyone says,
amen.
Thank you.
Okay. That was too long for like all the...
Hey, Alex, can I talk to you real quick? Hey, man, I was just going to ask you, bro, college a little bit.
A little bit.
Hey, how are your parents doing?
My parents, you know, it's actually a funny story because they love each other, but it's just a little hard love, you know?
Problems with the house.
Yeah, my mom and my dad, they're actually going through, it's been rough, honestly. There's just some things that are like a little bit of...
And your brother, Johnny? And
Johnny, actually...
I haven't seen him, I mean...
Yeah, I mean, we just... I need to tell him.
Can I talk to you?
You know, I'm...
Hey, I mean, that's fine. I mean, we could talk on Sunday if you want.
No, you know what? I actually would love to talk to you right now, too.
Yeah, well, you know what?
If you could just give me a sec real quick.
Okay.
Is that okay? Sarah. Hey.
Alex, I've been wanting to talk to you. I really need to tell you something.
No, hey. I want you to know something, okay? I have something to tell you too. Whatever it is, baby, that you're going through, I want you to know that I'm gonna stick through it with you, okay? Go with me. Pastor Jake, what were you gonna tell us?
Yeah, it's just that I know your family is going through a lot, but if you don't have God in your family, how can you expect it to work? You know, I mean, if you think just coming to a Bible study is gonna make your family all better, understand that it takes more than that. I know that God wants to do something with your life, and I know, Alex, you've been coming for a Bible study, and I know you've been here, but just understand that what we are preaching is so you can take it wherever you are at. You know, I know you might get influences from your friends. They might want to invite you to a nightclub or whatnot, but just know, you know what? God has a plan for you, but also the enemy has a plan for you. So I pray that everything that we've been preaching, everything that we've been doing here at this Bible study, the people that have been coming, you've been seeing here, just know that just the way you see all of them here, I mean, they come to Bible study, they're here at class, and they talk, they hang around with the cliques, but who knows? I'm pretty sure some of them might not even be paying attention to me during the Bible study. I know that. But you know what? I'm going to preach the Word of God, regardless if people listen to it or not.
Right.
But my desire is, you know what, that every person that comes and hears the gospel, that their heart may be open to receive everything that God has for them. So let me pray for you, Alex, and pray for your family. And I mean, I'm not too sure what's going on with you guys, but is that fine?
Yeah, actually, I would love that, honestly.
Lord, I come before you, Lord, and I pray for Alex. Lord, I just pray for whatever situation he is going through, whatever he is experiencing, Lord, at this time. It might be something difficult, Lord. It might be something that perhaps is impossible or seems impossible for him. Lord, I pray that you just help him, Lord. I pray that you may give him, Lord, the best direction that he needs in his life at this moment. In the name of Jesus Christ, I pray. Amen. Amen. I want to sit down and talk to you a little bit more.
Yeah, we should actually do that.
All right.
Today, maybe. I mean, I'd love to.
Okay.
Thanks, Pastor Jake. Appreciate it. Awesome.
God, there we go. You know, some of these scenes really broke my heart. You know, we believe at this church that there is hope, but we also believe in the reality of hell. And as we saw some of these scenes, I understand that the Bible says that it is destined for a man to live once and then after that to face judgment. But my heart breaks because I believe that there are some of you in this audience today that are experiencing hell. Hell at home, hell at school, hell all around you. But I'm here to offer you a word of hope. Hope is found in one person, and it is the person of Jesus Christ. See, the Bible tells us in John 10:10 that the thief comes but to kill, steal, and destroy. But Jesus says, I've come to give hope. I've come to give life and give it abundantly. Today, we have to make that choice. And I'm here to tell you that if you're coming to church, or maybe this is your first time here, and your parents are going through a difficult situation, you're living hell at home, maybe your parents are experiencing divorce or separation, or maybe you've been contemplating suicide. Suicide is not the way out. Drugs is not the way out. Alcohol is not the way out. What we need today, and what we need to hear loudly more than ever before, is that the way out is found through one person, and that is the person of Jesus Christ. You can come to church, go through the motions, and know how to sing the songs, but if you don't have a personal, vibrant, living relationship with Jesus Christ, you're lost. We need to make a choice. We need to decide, do we choose life or do we choose death? God is here to give you hope. You might feel like you don't have hope. There is hope. There is hope. You know, these scenes that we saw are so real. Tomorrow, I will be performing my grandmother's funeral. On Thursday, I received a phone call that she is just, you know, my grandmother-in-law, she's just minutes away from leaving planet Earth. And she said, I want you to be my pallbearer. And I started to talk to her, and I said, Grandma, and I looked at her in the eyes, do you know where you're going? And she said, yes, mijo. I'm going with Jesus. And she shared something with me that I'm going to carry for the rest of my life. She said, I don't understand. And I got closer to her. She had struggled breathing. She only has one lung. And I got closer, and I said, what do you mean, grandmother? And she said, I don't understand why I have so much peace. I don't understand why I don't have fear. I don't understand why I don't feel anxiety. And there she is on her deathbed, not understanding. And I told her, it's because you have Jesus. It's because you have the peace of God, which transcends all understanding. It's God. And yesterday she went home to be with the Lord. Deuteronomy chapter 30, verse 19. We need to make a decision. We need to make a choice. Say, today I have given you the choice between life and death, between blessings and cursings. Now I call on heaven and earth to witness the choice you make. Oh, that you would choose life today, young person, mother, father, grandparent, whoever you are. Today you must choose life. You make that choice today. Have you made that choice? I don't care how broken you are, or how messed up, how jacked up your life may seem right now. There is hope. And that hope is found in Jesus. You don't have to face that difficult storm, that difficult situation on your own. Jesus is there. He is real. He's not just a fictitious picture or a figure that we talk about. He is a person. He is a living God. Oh, that you would choose life. I don't know who I'm talking to, but if one person out of all of you today, if one person makes that decision today to choose life, this is all worth it. That you may live. God came to give life. You know, we are living in the end times, and we're living in a time of a broken world. And many of you related to some of the scenes that you saw up here. You're living and experiencing hell. You know, God can give you peace in the middle of a storm. Choose life today. And I'll wrap it up with one more scripture. Revelation chapter 20, verse 11 tells us about the reality of hell, about the destiny of man. It says, "And I saw a great white throne, and one sitting on it. The earth and the sky fled from his presence, but they found no place to hide." You know, one day we will find no place to hide. "I saw the dead, both great and small, standing before God's throne. And the books were open, including the book of life. And the dead were judged according to what they had done, as recorded in the books." Do you know that everything we do, everything we see, everywhere we go, every thought we think is being recorded in a book? And one day we will be judged. But those that have accepted Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior, the Bible tells us that the blood of Jesus washes our sins away. And no matter what you've done, no matter how bad you've been, or how many times you've done it, the blood of Jesus cleanses you, washes you, and God is able to forgive and to forget. You know, some of you have committed crimes nobody knows about. Some of you have done drugs and your parents don't even know about it. Some of you might be here today and you've cheated on your husband, you've cheated on your wife, and no one knows about it. But I'm here to tell you that God does know. And you know what? If you come to Jesus, He can heal your pain. He can give you a new start, and He can give you a new heart. All you need to do is be sincere and be real with yourself. Stop lying to yourself. Church, stop lying. Church isn't good enough. Religion isn't good enough. What we need is a relationship with Jesus. And it continues to say, that verse that we'll pick up, it says that they weren't able to halt the sight. "I saw the dead, both great and small, standing before God's throne. And the books were open, including the book of life. And the dead were judged according to what they had done, as recorded in the books. The sea gave up its dead, and death and the grave gave up their dead. And all were judged according to their deeds. Then death and the grave were thrown into the lake of fire. This is the lake of fire, is the second death. And anyone whose name was not recorded in the book of life was thrown into the lake of fire." Is your name recorded in the book of life? You know, this city records all of its names that have been born in San Antonio. If you lost your birth certificate, you can go to downtown and you can go get a birth certificate. But I'm asking you today, is there a birth certificate about your new birth? About you coming to Jesus in heaven? Is your name recorded in heaven? We need to be sure. We need to wake up that there is a real hell. And we can't experience a real hell even here while we're on earth. But there is hope, and that hope is found in the gospel message of Jesus Christ. I want to pray for you today. And I want to ask God to bring help and bring hope to those that have lost all hope. I don't know your situation, but God does. I believe that there are people experiencing pain. And you know, salvation is not about raising up your hand or praying a special prayer or going through a ritual or going through a formula. Salvation is about calling on the name of God. We don't have altar space here today. But if you call on Him, Romans chapter 10 tells us, "Whoever calls on the name of the Lord shall be saved." What touched my heart is that young lady was there as she committed that awful and dreadful act of abortion. She called on the name of Jesus and God came to her. No matter how bad you've been, no matter how much you've messed up, if you call on Jesus, if you call on Jesus, if you call on Jesus, He will save you. He will forgive you. He will give you life. Oh God, we thank you today. Every head bowed, every eye closed. Just call on Jesus. Maybe you don't even have the strength to talk and speak out loud. Maybe you don't even know how to pray or what to say. All I ask you to do is just to say the name. Just to say the name. Just to say the name that is above every name. Just say, Jesus, I need your help. Jesus, I need the salvation of my soul. Jesus, I need you to forgive me. That's all you need to do. And He will forgive you. And then ask Jesus to come into your life and change you, to give you a new heart. In your own words, express yourself to the Lord. There's no magic formula or special prayer. I can help you and I can guide you. All you need to say is, Jesus, help me. I'm experiencing hell at home. Help me, Jesus. I'm experiencing hell at school. Jesus, I'm experiencing hell and I'm thinking about suicide. I'm thinking about doing this, Lord. Help me and He will help you. The thief comes but to kill, steal, and destroy. But He has come to give life and give it abundantly. Father God, we declare upon your people today and upon each and every person that has stepped, Lord God, foot upon this sanctuary. We speak a word of faith. We speak a word of hope. And we speak life right now. And we rebuke all spirit of death, all spirit of suicide, all spirit of drug addiction, all spirit of hopelessness. Lord God, right now, we invite the divine spirit of the Holy Spirit to come and invade this place. I pray that you would put conviction. I pray that you would convince each and every person that is here today that you have a plan, that you have a destiny, that you have a future for them, and that there is hope, and that there is help, and that there is healing, and it is found in Jesus, Jesus. If you want Jesus today, just call on His name. Just say, Jesus, I need you. I need you in my life. I need you in my marriage. I need you, God. I need your forgiveness. I understand today that I need to make a decision between life and death. You make that decision. I'm going to ask everyone to stand up on your feet today. And as I said before, there's no room for an altar call. We're experiencing tremendous growth in this church, and we thank God for that. And I'm going to ask for those that made that decision, every head bowed, every eye closed, we're about to dismiss. I'm going to ask for those that made that decision. I don't want to embarrass you. I just want to know if you made that decision. Maybe if you recommitted your life to God today. And maybe this drama was an instrument, a tool to wake up your spirit, man, to wake up your conscience about the reality of hell. I'm going to ask if you want Jesus, if you need hope. Or maybe you are saved right now. Maybe you come to church. Maybe you serve at church, but you're experiencing a living hell at home. Your parents are constantly fighting and speaking about divorce. You're playing around with drugs. You're messing around with your girlfriend and committing fornication and having sex outside of marriage. And you're saying to yourself, is this all there is to life today? Come to Jesus. Come to Jesus. And if that's you, I'm going to ask you just to raise up your hand real quick up in the air. If you need hope, if you need salvation, and put it back down. Raise it up real quickly and put it back down. God is seeing those hands going up. Father God, they are committing to you. Some of those hands are going up because they need salvation. Some of those hands are going up because they need forgiveness of sins. Some of those hands are going up today, God, because they're experiencing helplessness and hopelessness at home, at school. They're experiencing the reality of hell even as I speak right now. And I pray that your Holy Spirit begin to minister. Call on the name of Jesus. That's all you need to do. Just say, Jesus, I need salvation. I need forgiveness. I need to find a way out of this situation. I need you to touch my parents' marriage. I need you to touch me, Lord God. I need hope. I need help. I'm addicted to drugs. I'm addicted to pornography. I'm addicted to alcohol. I'm addicted, Lord God. I need help, and I need hope. Call on Jesus. Call on Jesus. If all you can do today is call on the name that saved me and saved so many others, just call on Him. Father God, we call on You today. Oh God, who shall we go to if only You have words that give life? Who shall we go to, God? Father God, I bless those that have committed to You today their lives. And I bless those, Lord God, that are in desperate need of help. Help them through Your Holy Spirit. And we bless them today. And write the names of those that committed, Lord God, their lives to You for the very first time. The book of life. We thank You, Lord God. In Jesus' name, we praise Your name. Oh, let's worship God for a couple of moments. We thank You for coming. May the Lord bless you.
You are the source. I can't be left behind. No one else will do. And I will take hold of You, 'cause I need You, Jesus, to come to my rescue. Where else can I go? There's no other name by which I am saved. Capture me with grace, and I will follow You.